Sensei is a Japanese word that means teacher. And I teach Ishinru Karate for the Recreation Department of Bethel Park at Bethel Park Community Center. I've been in Ishinru Karate for over half a century. And it's been my observation, the violence is always emphasized, but the better virtues of karate is seldom seen. In this series, my purpose is to acquaint you, the viewer, with the benefits of martial arts training in general and Ishinru Karate specifically. So whether you are a martial artist already, or whether you're a person who's thought of taking martial arts, or if you're someone with no interest whatsoever in martial arts, I think you'll find this program to be a benefit to you. My name is Chuck Wallace, but my students call me Sensei.
Hello and welcome to this episode of My Students Call Me Sensei. My name is Josh Mell. This episode is a tribute to the founder of the series, Hanshi Charles Wallace. It is with great sadness that this will be the final episode with the passing of Hanshi Wallace on May 21st, 2019. In this episode, we will be chronicling his career in Ishinru Karate and hearing from several of his students. Hanshi Wallace began training in Ishinru Karate at the age of 23 in the city of Pittsburgh. Here he met a man named William Dissel, who would become his lifelong sensei, friend, and business partner. These two men were pioneers of Ishinru Karate in southwestern Pennsylvania. Both men have trained under Harry Smith, ninth degree black belt. Hanshi Wallace obtained his black belt in the summer of 1967. He is a charter member of the Ishinru World Karate Association, holding membership number 69. Both men have trained directly under Ishinru's founder, Tatsuo Shimabuku, when he visited Pittsburgh for 3 months in 1967. With Hanshi Wallace's passing, we have lost a direct link to the roots of Ishinru Karate. Beginning in 1970, Hanshi Dissel and Hanshi Wallace opened a karate school, the Academy of Ishinru Karate in Pittsburgh. This school operated throughout the 1970s and at its peak had an enrollment of over 500 students. In the summer of 2013, Mr. Wallace was promoted to ninth dan by Hanshi William H. Dissel and Kichiro Shimabuku and was presented with the designation of Hanshi Go. Also in that same year, he was inducted into the Ishinru Hall of Fame, having previously received a Lifetime Achievement Award from the same organization in 2010. Hanshi Wallace began this series with the first episode uploaded to YouTube on September 14, 2015. And his last filmed episode was uploaded on March 24, 2019. He filmed a total of 21 episodes for Bethel Park TV, which were uploaded to YouTube. We would now like to introduce you to some of Hanshi Wallace's students, some of whom you may have seen in prior episodes. They will tell you something of Hanshi Wallace and demonstrate a few of the things he has taught.
Hello, my name is Marty Prentice. I'm Kiyoshi Marty Prentice. I'm with the Ishinru Karate Academy at Pittsburgh. I've known Hanshi Wallace for about 42 years, 43 years, before exact. He was my third instructor. I started with Russell Best and came to Pittsburgh in 73 and started working with Hanshi Dissel and Hanshi Wallace, and we've worked together ever since. We've been close friends and one of my closest instructors. I would like to perform chart one, number 10, which is one is the basic leg block, and the other is a bridge of the nose, a rising block, the bridge of the nose, and also maybe Wansu Kata. Hanshi Wallace always used to talk about the weapon and the target, and in this case, when we do the leg block, we will come down and do a leg block, showing the focus of the fist and also the punch to the target area of the solar plexus. Thank you.
Number 10. Hello, my name is Thomas Laurent. I'm an eighth Dan with the Ishinru Karate Academy. I am glad to be here to honor Hanshi Charles A. Wallace, a lifelong friend I've known over 30 years. It was he who gave me my first karate lesson and actually signed me up for karate. He took me off into a room which was basically for beginners, taught me chart one, chart two. He was a dedicated, detailed, and enthusiastic instructor, and it made a huge impression on me. And our friendship would only grow through the years, and eventually we were able to travel the United States for tournaments, seminar, and karate-related activities, and I will always cherish that. Today, I would like to perform a couple things that strike thoughts in my mind of Hanshi Wallace, and that is the basics. Number seven, open hand side block. He was very detailed in regards to positioning of the fingers and the hands. Along with number 13, chop and then chop to the base of the neck. You'll see a very similar look. And finally, number 14, which is the parry and two rib strikes, of which were some of his favorites and felt that they were very strong techniques. At the end of that, I will perform Sanshin, which is a moving meditation. And Hanshi Wallace was very involved and believed strongly in meditation itself for self-development. Thank you very much.
Number seven, chart one. Number 13, chart one. Number 14, commonly referred to as the biggie block and biggie punch. And now I will perform Sanshin Kata.
My name is Marty Dugan. I've been affiliated with two very top senseis since I started my Ishinru Karate training in the early 80s, William H. Distel and Charles A. Wallace. The two gentlemen met at a chance encounter at a seminar that was being held by Master Tatsuo Shimabuku near the Pittsburgh area of Pennsylvania. The two of them became lifelong friends, eventually opened their own school, and continued karate training all of their life. Hanshi William H. Distel, who had former martial arts training and was as dedicated to the art as any, became the lead man. And Hanshi Wallace became his top student and associate. He was a loyal, hardworking, optimistic practitioner who trained with Master Distel for 50 years. Both are gone now, but their spirits live on through us. The reason I'm speaking about both is because they were a perfect team. They worked tremendously well with one another. If I can give an analogy, a Terry Bradshaw and a Lynn Swan on the gridiron, they rode with one another. And to be in their company during those days was more than educational, but downright fun. Hanshi Wallace's love for the art came out of his pores. He was a dedicated daily practitioner who truly believed his purpose in life was to teach Ishinru Karate to the best of his ability. Through much diligent training, he loved to practice and teach both charts 1 and 2 and kata alike. Even though he seemed to have an overwhelming love for the charts, the basics, with proper form being the pinnacle, Hanshi Wallace, being in his 70s in age, came to believe that one of the greatest secrets was to be as relaxed and tension-free as possible, even though in practice, it is monumentally harder to do. But he stressed this practice over and over and over again. He practiced and taught for a person to relax and become as tension-free as possible and incorporate this with deep belly breathing and moving from your center. He left us fairly quickly after his diagnosis and died courageously with grace. May the name Charles A. Wallace live on in the annals of Ishinru Karate, and may the title Hanshi, which means teacher of teachers, always be associated with his name. I will perform a kata that Hanshi Wallace really enjoyed performing in his younger years. It's a weapons kata, the bow staff, and the kata Tokomini no Kun.
My name is Larry Krause. I've gotten to know Hanshi Wallace back in 92. Hanshi Wallace and I have been training at 7:30 every Wednesday morning since 92. Hanshi was a great role model in my life. Not only did he teach me a lot about the martial arts, but he taught me a lot about life. Back in the 60s at one time, he actually, before Chuck Norris became a movie star, Hanshi actually did a tournament with Chuck Norris. And then back in the early 60s, Hanshi Dissel and Hanshi Wallace had, Bruce Lee was supposed to be coming in and doing a part in help promoting the school. I wasn't able to come and Hanshi Wallace did one Su. Hanshi was very big on the Makiwara boards. Over his life, he done a lot of breakage. And so every Wednesday morning, we worked the Makiwara board and also the heavy bag. So what I'd like to do today is introduce a little bit of some of the techniques that Hanshi Wallace had shared with me with the Makiwara board and Mr. Bob. Hanshi liked working on Mr. Bob and doing a lot of combinations. And one of the things that Hanshi always stressed is the element of surprise. And so he would always, the first technique I want to show you is one of the things that Hanshi would do all the time. he would always put his hands up and say, "You don't want any trouble, Miss. We don't want any trouble, Mr. Bob." And then he would do his Palm Hill strike. And that was one of his favorite strikes. And the other thing I'm going to do is that he did a double strike, one to the throat and a Palm Hill to the solar plexus. And then I'll finish up with one of the combinations with the elbow strikes. Mr. Bob, we don't want any trouble. I'm just going to share with you a couple of techniques that Hanshi did just 2 weeks before he had moved on and passed away from this life. But this kick I'm going to do is a unique kick that Hanshi had come up with. It's a combination between a crescent kick and a roundhouse kick. And it's something that we worked on every single Wednesday since 1992. And I always had a problem with it, but Hanshi could master this thing, but that's the first thing I'd like to share with you. And then the second thing that he always liked was some of the combinations he did. He did a one-inch punch. I'd like to demonstrate that. And also, he used the knife edge with a palm heel strike, a combination on the Makiwara board. And then with all that, he always used a lot of ki eyes. So I would just like to share this with you and dedicate this to Hanshi Wallace. And this is what he had given us. And the power that he had was just totally amazing. Behind this Makiwara board, I had somebody place a piece of steel. And Hanshi bent that steel. So that tells you how powerful he is. And I think his birthday is going to be, he was going to be 79 in November. And he's still quick and fast and very powerful. And what a blessing he's been to everybody that has known him. One of the other favorite things that Hanshi liked to do was an elbow strike. I'd like to demonstrate that before I demonstrate the others. One of the things that he really stressed is that when you don't come around with the elbow, you come straight in and using the very point of the elbow as the striking point.
My name's Neil Scarrato. I'm with the Ishinru Karate Academy of Pittsburgh. I've been with the Ishinru Karate Academy of Pittsburgh on and off for about 45 years. I first met Hanshi Wallace in the early 70s. I was at the time enamored with the Bruce Lee craze and the Kung Fu TV show. And after going to a less than reputable karate school, I was guided to the Academy of Ishinru Karate by a friend of mine, Richard Myers, who was getting his black belt at the Ishinru Karate School. After watching him get his black belt, I immediately quit the other karate school and joined the Academy of Ishinru Karate. After joining the Academy of Ishinru Karate, Mr. Wallace was the first person, at the time he was Sensei Wallace, was the first person that we interacted with. There was a room in the rear of the dojo that he very meticulously went over the entire first chart. He had little special exercises that he used to like to do because karate wasn't really first nature for American athletics. So one of the things that he always liked to work on, and it was a little awkward, there were difficult times practicing these exercises, but he loved working the wrist and manipulating the wrist, especially on number 10 on the first chart, which was a bridge of nose strike. I remember when I was driving, I would practice at red lights. I got many a strange look at people at the red lights when they'd see me with my hand, with my fist to my ear, trying to practice that wrist. Another one of Hanshi Wallace's favorite techniques was a variation on the leg block. We were taught one way of the leg block was blocking with the fist out. Hanshi Wallace very astutely observed that if you block a kick to the groin, you needed to turn the fist outward to effectively block the lower extremity. So he changed the side block from this normal traditional way to turning the side block sideways, which was a little more effective for a lower block. Those are two of the most influential aspects that Hanshi Wallace taught me. Seiuchin kata.
Hello, my name is Josh Mell, and I began training at the Ishin Karate Academy in August of 1996. While having the privilege of training under many excellent instructors, I did also get to train under Hanshi William Dissel and Hanshi Charles Wallace. And one of the more interesting things of training that can occur often occurs during the car rides to and from events. And just a couple of things that occurred. One time, Kiyoshi Prentice, whom you met earlier, Hanshi Wallace and I were traveling back from an event in Ohio. We were traveling along the Pennsylvania Turnpike, and out of nowhere, three deer vaulted this 8-foot-high barrier through, coming running on the highway, and I don't know how we managed to miss them, but fortunately we did. And Hanshi Wallace would often refer to that event many times over. And another interesting thing that Hanshi Wallace taught me while on one of our numerous car rides was when you wake up every morning at the beginning of the day, before you do anything else, to do chart 2, number 3. And I'm going to demonstrate that for you, followed by Naihanshi Kata. Hanshi Wallace really liked Naihanshi Kata. He felt it didn't get the attention it deserved because it was a short kata. And I also remember having the privilege of him asking me to demonstrate this kata at a seminar at the World Tournament in 2015. So that kind of creates a personal connection for me to Hanshi Wallace and some of the things we did. So I will be demonstrating that for you today. Chart 2, number 3. Hanshi kata.
Mark Lent, Kusong Ku Sai Kata.
Olivia Mariuto Wansu Kata.
Natalie Mariuto, my Hanshi Kata.
Anthony Martinelli, Seisan Kata.
Arnold Shoulder, Seisong Kata. I'd first like to tell a story how I came to karate a year and a half ago. Hanshi Wallace was a good friend of mine. He was one of my patients for 25 years, and he became my sensei for a year and a half. This all started about a year and a half ago. Hanshi Wallace was in my office for an appointment, and he was in the exam room. It was all quiet. I walked into the room, and Hanshi Wallace was sitting there meditating with his eyes fixed on a placard I had taped very securely to the wall that said, "No handshaking, flu season." As I walked in, he continued to stare with his hands resting on his knees calmly, and the placard fell off the wall. And he lost his trance and he looked at me, and I said, "Master Wallace." And he said, "Yes." I said, "How did you do that? How did that fall off the wall?" And he said, very calmly, "I think it was my chi." And I said, "Can you teach me that?" And that's how it came that I started Ishinryu Karate with Hanshi Wallace.
My name is Chuck Wallace, but my students call me Sensei.